In this video, I'll show you how you can use Telestream's ScreenFlow to create this effect and transform a flat screenshot into a pseudo 3D animation that makes it much more sophisticated. The original video right now exists as a 5-second flat basic screen capture done directly in ScreenFlow. What we need to do in order to create the 3D effect is separate the elements into foreground and background. There's a very easy way to do this in ScreenFlow. I'm going to highlight my screen capture here, then hit Command C to copy it to the clipboard. Then, after I make sure to hit rewind to the beginning so the cursor is at the beginning, I'm going to hit Command V to paste it back on the timeline. What ScreenFlow does is paste a new copy of the screen capture, identical to the original and perfectly synced, in a new layer. So now you can optionally rename the two layers as foreground and background. Just so you can see what I'm doing clearly, let's move the background out of the way temporarily so we can just concentrate on the foreground. I'm going to highlight the foreground clip and come over here to the first tab, the Video Properties tab, and open up the cropping panel, and start to crop the foreground so I can isolate just the frontmost window I want to focus on. To save time, I've already figured out what these numbers are supposed to be. So now I've cropped just the window I want to focus on. Once that's done, I can move the background back in place to the original location. It looks seamless because we haven't changed the positions of either layer, but now we can start to treat the foreground and the background independently of each other. The next thing we want to do is start to tweak the starting animating position, or orientation, of the two layers, and we'll choose very similar settings for each. Let's start with the background, for example. I'm going to come to the Video Properties tab and scale it to be a lot larger, say 150%. Then set up rotation with X at negative 10, Y at 10, and Z at 10. That should work. Now, because this is the background, I actually want the viewer's eyes to be drawn to the foreground. So I'll come to the color controls and I'm going to darken the background a little bit by reducing the brightness. I might add a little bit of contrast too. And I'll also add a little bit of blur. I'll go to blur, then Gaussian blur, and use a small radius, about 3. Great, so that's the starting position for my background. Now the next thing I want to do is click on my foreground and do the same thing. I like the scale to be slightly larger on this, say 180%, so that the two layers change at slightly different rates, giving it more of a feeling of perspective as the two layers move in relation to each other. I'll set up the same rotation as the background. On this one, I'll add a little bit of shadow to help it lift off the background, say at a negative 90 degree angle, an offset of 15, 30% opacity, and a blur size of 10. So at this point, we've got great starting positions for both the foreground and the background. The next thing to do is to decide on the ending positions for each layer, and we do that by adding a video action to each layer, which is like an animation. We can do either first, but let's start with the foreground. So with the foreground clicked, I'll click Add Video Action. Since the cursor is set to the end of the video action, let's tell it where we want the foreground to finish. We'll do a slightly smaller scale of 150 degrees, and set all of the X, Y, and Z rotations back to 0. We'll do the same thing with the background. Add a video action, and set the endpoints of the video action to 100% zoom, and reset all the rotations to 0. Now the last thing we need to do is stretch the two video actions so that they last the full 5 seconds. And now let's sit back and watch our animation. And that's how you do 3D front window focus in ScreenFlow. I hope you enjoyed this quick tutorial.